As David Gorski, a respected medical ethicist, reminds us, science-based medicine depends upon human experimentation. Without human testing, scientists will never know if the products of the research will perform as they are intended to heal real human patients, to cure a disease, or to eradicate a lethal virus. There's simply no substitute for clinical trials that experiment on human subjects, and therein lies the ethical conundrum. It turns out that the most scientifically rigorous trial design might not be the most ethical. As you'll discover from the readings in this module, the history of human experimentation in the 20th century is particularly repugnant. The gruesome syphilis experiments conducted by the United States government in Alabama and Guatemala, the intentional infecting with hepatitis of mentally retarded children at the Willowbrook State School on Staten Island, and the Pfizer Corporation's meningitis experiment in Nigeria. These three alone would suffice to make us ask whether clinical trials are inherently exploitative. And yet, it is just as clear that they are needed in order for medical science to advance. Consequently, we need to think very clearly about the ethics of human experimentation and the mechanisms in place to protect human participants, including informed consent, risk disclosure, non-maleficence, and the correct formulation of a scientific protocol. As always, we need to ask the question of cui bono, who benefits? The participants in the third world country where the experiment occurred? The large pharmaceutical company that used the data from the experiment to successfully launch the drug? The patients who were prescribed the drug? Intuitively, we know that we should neither exploit nor objectify a fellow human. But why? What is the philosophical rationale for such a position? Our text presents two very different views, one based on Immanuel Kant's deontological, or duty-driven, ethics, and the other on the basis of a version of John Stuart Mill's utilitarian approach, specifically act consequentialism. Now, while these technical terms may sound obscure, their practical application is very straightforward. If human experiments are necessary, we need a solid ethical foundation for their conduct. And that is what you'll be exploring in both your essay and the discussion board for this unit. Along the way, you'll read a landmark document on medical research ethics called the Nuremberg Code, named after the German city that hosted the trials of Nazi war criminals at the end of the Second World War. You'll also hear commentary from the physician and medical historian who chaired the presidential committee on the legacy of the Tuskegee Syphilis Experiment, and you'll read a closely reasoned journal article on the regulatory and ethical principles in research that involve children and individuals with developmental disabilities. The article argues that the history of biomedical research over the past 50 years shows that children and individuals with developmental disabilities represent populations that are especially susceptible to human rights violations, and that the codes that govern research on human participants do not yet apply with equal force to such vulnerable groups. Clearly, special ethical challenges remain. Well, that's it. I think you'll find this unit both historically relevant and intellectually stimulating. Best wishes for a productive 2 weeks.